Good afternoon. There's a couple things of reminder. For those that maybe are new to the Hymn Fest, you have in front of you all that you need. You have your music you can sing along with. You have the responsive readings. Please enter in with lots of gusto, okay? Sing with your heart. Also, during the responsive readings, we'll be asking you to stand in reverence of God's word, and then ask you to stay standing for the first hymn after that. And then I will, after that, seat you so that you're not standing the entire time. Unless you want to stand for an hour and a half, just go for it. Or if you cannot stand at all, that's just fine. You can worship seated. God understands. And so again, thank you for coming. And may God bless this time with you.
We do want to thank you for being here. If you look at your program, on the very first page is listed the verse Romans 5:8 that says, "But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us." And that verse has been the theme for our chapels this year, and we've been looking specifically at those two words, "but God," because so many times throughout Scripture, we see that people, because of our sin, we get ourselves into all kinds of trouble, but God in his kindness and grace and love turns those stories around for his glory. And so we've been looking at those stories all year in our chapels. And so we're going to celebrate the fact that God does so many times intervene in our stupidity to turn things around for his glory. And that's going to be the focus of our time together today. And so, again, Hymn Fest is a team sport, so we really need you to be a part of this, and especially the responsive readings. It's so cool when God's people read his word together. So I will go ahead and ask you to stand for our first responsive reading, which is on the first page there, or I guess in a little bit. And before we start that, let us open with a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that you would open our ears so that we may hear your voice. Open our minds so that we may receive your eternal wisdom. We ask that you would open our spirits so that we may know your leading and guidance. And open our hearts so that we may receive your wonderful love. Father, we also ask that you receive this singing as a gift to you today and use it to add to your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Romans 5:1-6. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand. And we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. You see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly.
Glory, glory, glory.
Will you stand with me as we continue to read from Romans? Romans 3, 9 through 18. What shall we conclude then? Do we have any advantage? Not at all. For we have already made the charge that Jews and Gentiles alike are all under the power of sin. As it is written,
there is no one righteous, not even one. There is no one who understands. There is no one who seeks God. All have turned away. They have together become worthless. There is no one who does good, not even one. Their throats are open graves. Their tongues practice deceit. The poison of vipers is on their lips. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Ruin and misery mark their ways, and the way of peace they do not know. There is no fear of God before their eyes.
Thank you.
Wonder how he loved me, our Savior.
At this point, we'd like to invite you to consider how you might be able to help the music program continue to offer programs like this. It's through generous gifts that they're able to help and serve the community in a lot of different ways. There are a couple different ways of doing that today. One is, on the way out, as you exit later, in the foyer, there'll be a donation box where you can give physical gifts, cash or checks, or secondly, If you want to give electronically, there's a QR code in the very back that you can use to navigate that way to give electronically. So as you enjoy the offertory, we'll just invite you to think about ways that you can invest in the music program. Let's say a word of prayer for the offering. Father, we thank you so much for the gifts and the givers today. We pray that all the gifts that are given will be multiplied for your service, and that you will bless the givers to know that that your kingdom is being advanced. And we thank you again in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
Will you please stand as we continue to read from Romans? Romans 5, 8 through 11. But God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Much more then, having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath of God through him. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more, having been reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. And not only this, but we also celebrate in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received the reconciliation.